Okay, we got the pool up. It took about an hour and a half, 2 hours to get it all together. Got water in it, but now there's a flaw. The cover that comes with it, it's got two flaw screens. I can't see this really good in here on this. I got it right there. And we have it snug. But see now, you've got that pump right there. Again, I can't see this viewfinder out here with the sun around. Let's see if I can clean this a little bit. Oh, shit, that didn't help. Anyway, there's a pump right there. I can't see it, but I'm pointing right at it. It covers over that. We put a garden hose on top of it because the wind is about, looks like it's going to take this thing off. Now, look at the threatening sky. That's west. That's west right there. Straight back behind that little hopper thing next to the shed. It's west. You see the clouds coming in like a storm. So I just took 45 minutes in here vacuuming out this pool, vacuumed it the day before yesterday, and I've been skimming the top out of it ever since. I'm from the outside of the pool and inside it today. And I got this water clean. And I wasn't about to let it rain and screw it all up again because we got a tree right here and right by the pool that leaves do fall and get inside in little pieces of branches, and we have bugs inside the thing and everything else. So after I cleaned it for 45 minutes today, vacuuming for 45 minutes, skimming it for the last 2 days roughly, we put this cover on here. But now the cover, as you can see, every time the wind picks up, now watch, when it storms, if it storms, that cover is probably going to fly off. Like I said, even with the garden hose on this weight, I don't put too much more weight than that. There needs to be something a little bit, clips to go around the top, even with the holes out here. Let's see. You know, it looks like a little, well, still now. God, I can't see this in the day in the sun. Right here, it's like a Y. Clip on each one of these, even that would help a lot more. Just plastic clamps like you do on that top of a potato chip or something like that, even would be a great help. If I could find something like that, I'll improvise myself. So summer escapes, guys, need to revamp your designs here. Look at this. See, I got the, if I didn't have that garden hose on there, that thing would probably flip off already. And I'm afraid that if it has high winds later today, that tomorrow morning I'm gonna wake up and the garden hose will be in the pool and the cover will be probably off in a damn field or something, because poor design. I don't know any other way other than put it over the top and pull the drawstring on both sides. We got both of them snug. You know, I don't want to pour on it because then to me, I might end up loosening it up more. See, it should all come down below this, like that. It should go below this right here. But it should be snugger than that. See, need clamps to go on here and here on each side, all the way around, and that would secure the cover. But as you can see, the wind is bubbling up, and I can almost guarantee that tonight, if we do have storms or even just heavy rain like we've had here for a time, geez, it's amazing how freaky this weather is. It's almost like someone's controlling it, isn't it? Anyway. Tomorrow this cover will probably be off flying somewhere over there on the edge of one of these Monsanto feed corn fields, and the garden hose will be in the pool and it'll be contaminated with all kinds of shit and from the tree and just debris that's going to be blowing around. So summer escapes, or let me go back here and make sure I got the right name. I mean, I'm going to put blame on something. I'm going to make sure I'm saying the right person, the right company rather. Summer escapes. Okay, I can't really see. I think, yeah, right there. Summer escapes. You had a flaw in your design a little bit with your pool cover. Even if it had little strings that would go down to that band that the poles go in behind for secure for stabilization. You know, anything. But look at, like I say, this cover is going to be blown off of here. I can tell you right now. And we've got it snug on both ends, both the drawstring on each end. It's really snug. So unless you have a better solution with the existing cover, you know, you need to do something, because, you know, I'm not the only one who's got this pool, and I'm sure other people are going to have the same challenges I'm having. Poor design and the pool cover. That's all I can say. Anybody has any suggestions, comment, don't be ignorant, you know. I mean, no one wants to see anyone else's ignorance. If you're really ignorant, then I'll just put it on there so people can see it. So again, this is what it looks like. I'm going to try to email them and tell them to look it up on YouTube, Ozzyman1203.